Jai Hind, my dear children. Now we are moving towards the end of the chapter, Electric Potential and the Capacitance. So the topic is energy stored in a capacitor. We know capacitor is a device used to store electric charges. Okay, so how the capacitor is charged? By connecting it to the terminals of the battery. When capacitor is connected to the battery, one plate becomes fully positively charged and another becomes negatively charged. Right. So capacitor is a device used to store electric charges, and the capacitor is charged by connecting it to a battery. The work done in charging the capacitor is stored as potential energy. So work done in transferring the charges or charging the capacitor is actually storing as the potential energy of the capacitor, And the energy is supplied by the battery at the expense of stored chemical energy, because in the battery, chemical energy is stored. That chemical energy is converted to energy stored in the capacitor. So actually it is based on the law of conservation of energy. When the capacitor, two plates of the capacitor, when it is connected to the battery, chemical energy is converted to energy of the capacitor. Okay, so where the energy is stored, the energy is stored actually between the plates of the capacitor. Okay, children. Now, derivation for the energy stored in the capacitor. First, we can consider two uncharged plates. These are the two uncharged plates. One and two are the uncharged plates. And it is the two plates of the capacitor. It has capacitance C. Right. So initially the plates are uncharged. Second figure is, charges are taken from 2 to 1. Okay, small positive charges are being transferred from 2 to 1 bit by bit. Okay, one by one. So charges are being transferred from 2 to 1 bit by bit. And at an intermediate case, plate 2 becomes some negative charge, that is minus Q dash. And plate 1 becomes some positive charge, that is plus Q dash. That is, this is an intermediate case. Here the plates are not completely charged. This is only an intermediate case. So some positive charges here, some negative charges here. Okay. So positive charges are being transferred from 2 to 1 bit by bit, so that in an intermediate situation, plate 2 has some negative charge, that is minus Q dash, and plate 1 has some positive charge, which is plus Q dash. And the potential difference is given by V dash. Here also capacitance remains C. In all the case, capacitance remains C, because capacitance does not depend on charge. Capacitance does not depend on voltage. It depends only on the geometric configuration. Okay. So here capacitance is C, potential difference is V dash, and the charge B, Q dash. And again, after some time, all the charges are transferred from 2 to 1. So that the second plate gets fully negative charge and the first plate gets fully positive charge. This is a fully charged capacitor. This is the final situation. Okay, and here the potential difference be V, and the capacitance remains C only. So these are the three important cases. So first case, uncharged capacitor, two plates are uncharged. Second case, that is the intermediate situation where the plates having charges Q dash and the potential difference V dash. This is the final case where the plates are fully charged, plus Q and minus Q, and the potential difference be V. Okay, now consider the intermediate case. Suppose work done here, small work is done. We know work is done in transferring charge from 2 to 1, isn't it? Let dQ dash be the charges being transferred from 2 to 1. So what is the small work done in transferring dQ dash from 2 to 1? So work done in transferring dQ dash from 2 to 1 is, we know work is equal to charge into potential. Okay, so here which charge is transferred? dQ dash, that's a small charge is transferred. And what is the potential difference in the intermediate case? V dash. So dQ dash into V dash. Our work done is equal to, what is charge? We know that charge is equal to C into V, or V equal to Q by C. No, potential difference and capacitance are related by V equal to Q by C. And hence V dash can be written as Q dash divided by C into this dQ dash. This is a small work in transferring small charge dQ dash from 2 to 1. Now, what is the total work in transferring charges from 2 to 1 so that plate 1 is fully charged. Plate 1 is fully charged means plus Q. And plate 2 is fully charged, that is minus Q. So plate 2 is fully charged, which is minus Q. So how will you calculate the total work? We can integrate. Integrate dW, the small work, is equal to integrate. What is that small work? Q dash divided by C into dQ dash. Now we can apply the limits in the integration. Here initially the charges of the plate 0, fully uncharged. Finally becomes which charge? Q charge. So charges vary from 0 to which value? Q. So integration from 0 to Q. Limits from 0 to Q. Okay. So it's equal to 1 by C. It's a constant. Can be taken outside. 1 by C integral 0 to Q. Q dash into dQ dash. Then we have the formula for integration. Integral x raised to n dx is x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Isn't it? This is the formula for integration. So using that, we can write W work done is equal to 1 by C integral Q dash into dQ dash. So using the formula, we can write Q dash the into dQ dash integration, which is given by Q dash the whole raised to 1 n. N is 1, no? N plus 1, which is 2, divided by 2. Right. Limits 0 to is equal to 2 can be taken outside 1 by 2c and applying the limits. What are the limits here? Upper limit is q and the lower limit is 0. So upper limit, which is q square, minus lower limit, which is 0 square. Okay. So work done is equal to q square divided by 2c. We know from the definition work is stored as what? Energy. So energy or the potential energy stored in the capacitor is given by the formula Q square divided by 2C. Okay, so energy stored in the capacitor is given by U equals Q square divided by 2C. This is the potential energy stored in the capacitor. Okay, children. So we have the energy stored in the capacitor is given by U equals Q square divided by 2C. Energy stored in the capacitor is U equals Q square divided by 2C. Now, this can be considered as a first equation. Energy is stored in the capacitance relating charge and capacitance. Now, we have charge is equal to Q equal to CV, no? General formula, charge is equal to C into V. Using this, substituting, we can write energy equal to Q can be written as CV. So CV the whole square divided by 2C. So another formula comes, which is given by C and 1C get cancelled and half CV square. So another formula for energy stored in the capacitor is U equals half CV square. This is the second formula. Right. Now, this is the formula relating capacitance and potential difference. Now, another formula is also there. We have C is equal to, we have capacitance C is equal to Q by V, no? Capacitance C is equal to Q by V. Substituting in energy is equal to half CV square. In this formula, half CV square, we can substitute C as Q by V. Okay. Therefore, energy can be written as half C. What is C? Q by V. Q by V into V square. One V get cancelled. So, it is equal to half Q V. So, energy is also given by the formula half Q V. Okay. So, these are the three formula for energy stored in the capacitor. So, first one is charge and capacitance. U equal to half Q square divided by 2C. With capacitance and potential difference, energy is given by half CV square. With charge and potential difference, U equals half QV. Okay, so these are the formula relating energy stored in a capacitor. Okay. Now, we can take for a parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so for a parallel plate capacitor, for a parallel plate capacitor, we have capacitance is given by A epsilon 0 by D. So this is the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with air or vacuum as the dielectric. Right. Now capacitance is A epsilon 0 by D. We have derived the formula for energy U equals Q square divided by 2C. We can take any of the formula. Here I have taken U equal to Q square by 2C. So substituting capacitance is equal to A epsilon 0 by D. So energy becomes U equals Q square divided by 2C. What is C? A epsilon 0 by D. And D comes to the numerator, it becomes Q square D divided by 2A epsilon 0. Okay, no? Now, we have charge is equal to, we have charge, surface charge density is equal to charge by area, no? So we have the surface charge density between, surface charge density general formula is sigma is equal to charge divided by area. So using that, substituting sigma is equal to charge divided by area, we can write energy is equal to Q. What is Q? Sigma square. Q equal to sigma A, no? Q equal to sigma A. So sigma A square A square D divided by 2A epsilon 0. 1 A get cancelled. So it can be written as sigma square A D divided by 2 epsilon 0. Okay, now multiplying numerator and denominator by epsilon 0. Okay, one arrangement is doing multiplying numerator and denominator by epsilon 0. So energy becomes sigma square epsilon 0 AD divided by 2 epsilon 0 square. Already epsilon 0 is here. Multiplying by epsilon 0, it becomes sigma square epsilon 0 AD divided by 2 epsilon 0. Now, taking this, sigma square divided by epsilon 0 square. Are you remembering this formula? Sigma by epsilon 0. Okay, sigma by epsilon 0 is the energy stored, or sorry, it is the electric field between the two plates. Electric field between the positive charge plate and the equally negative charge plate is electric field E equals sigma divided by epsilon 0, isn't it? So sigma square by epsilon 0 can be written as electric field. So E square epsilon 0 AD divided by 2. This is another very important formula. Energy stored in a parallel plate capacitor is given by half epsilon 0 E square AD. Okay, so energy stored in a parallel plate capacitor is also given by U equals half epsilon 0 E square in addition to all other formula. Okay, now, so energy stored in a parallel plate capacitor is given by half epsilon 0 E square AD. Okay, now we are introducing a new term. Energy, this is energy, U represents the energy. Energy divided by volume. Energy per unit volume is called energy density, which is represented by small letter U. We know mass by volume, that is called mass density or otherwise called density. Okay, so anything divided by volume is called density. Mass by volume is mass density or otherwise it is called density. Charge by volume, that is called charge density. Volume charge density or cubical charge density or otherwise called charge density. So here energy divided by volume is called energy density, which is represented by U. So here energy by volume, what is the volume here in a parallel plate capacitor? Area into separation. Area into separation is volume, no? So energy divided by volume is equal to half epsilon 0 E square AD, that is energy by volume. What is the volume? AD. So it is equal to AdAd cancel, so half epsilon 0 E square, and which is called energy density half epsilon 0 E square. So this is a very, very important formula. Energy density of a parallel plate capacitor is given by U equal half epsilon 0 E square. Epsilon 0 is the permittivity of this free space. E represents the electric field between the two plates. Okay, so energy density of a parallel plate capacitor is half epsilon 0 E square. So just we can write all the formula for energy stored in a capacitor. Energy is given by Q square by 2C, first formula. Then another formula is energy is equal to half CV square. Energy is equal to QV divided by 2. And it is also given by half epsilon 0 E square AT. So these are the formula for energy stored in a capacitor. Okay, generally energy stored in a capacitor. Hope you understood this derivation for the energy stored in a capacitor. This is a very important question. Okay, children. Thank you.